I am Bishwajit Nath. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In the previous videos, I already discussed about electrostatics and current electricity. Today, our topic of discussion is combination of electric cells. I think you all enjoy my videos. Then please click the like button and please subscribe my channel. Your subscription encourages me to go further. Please subscribe my channel and watch my video. Our first topic of discussion is series combination of cells. Let n number of identical electric cells are connected in series with an external resistance capital R, and the current flowing through the circuit is capital I. Let n number of identical electric cells are connected in series with an external resistance R. I be the current passing through capital R. Epsilon be the EMF or electromotive force of each cell, and small r be the internal resistance of each cell. Let n number of identical electric cells are connected in series with an external resistance capital R. I be the current passing through capital R. Epsilon be the EMF of each cell, and small r be the internal resistance of each cell. Since all cells are connected in same order, therefore the total EMF of the circuit is capital E is equal to N into epsilon. That is, the cells are connected in the same order, that is plus minus, after the plus minus, and so on. Epsilon is the EMF of each cell. Therefore, total EMF of the circuit is E, capital E is equal to N into epsilon. And the total internal resistance of the circuit is N into small r. Since that cells are connected in series, we know the equivalent resistance of the resistors connected in series is number of resistors into resistance of each resistors, that is n into small r. Each cell has small r amount of internal resistance. That's why the total internal resistance is equal to n into small r. Therefore, the total resistance of the circuit is capital R plus n into small r. This is the total resistance of the circuit. Here R is the external resistance and n into small r is the total internal resistance. That's why capital R plus n into small r is the total resistance of this circuit. Therefore, current I is equal to total EMF divided by total resistance. This gives I is equal to n into epsilon by R plus n into small r. This is the expression of current passing through the external resistance capital R when the cells are connected in series. In the special case, case number one, when capital R is excessively greater than total internal resistance n into small r, that is when the external resistance is excessively greater than the total internal resistance, then we can neglect the internal resistance in the above expression. That's why we can write I approximately equal to n into small epsilon by r. Therefore, I is directly proportional to N. That is, the current is directly proportional to the number of cells connected in series. It is very useful for our practical purpose. In practice, the external resistance of the circuit is generally very much greater than the internal resistance of the circuit. That's why in many cases in our practical life we use this type of connection or series combination of cells. Case 2, when capital R is excessively less than the internal resistance of the cells, then we can neglect the value of capital R. Therefore, we can write I approximately equal to n epsilon by nr. This gives I is equal to epsilon by r. This is equal to current capital I is equal to small I. That is, current passing through the circuit is equal to the current produced by a single cell. That is, the current passing through the external circuit is independent on the number of cells in the connected in the circuit. That's why this type of connection in this case is not useful. That's why when the external resistance is very much smaller with respect to the internal resistance of the circuit, then we cannot use the series combination. Then we cannot use the series combination. This is the parallel combination of cells. Here the cells are connected parallelly, that is plus or positive poles of the cells are connected in the same point, and the negative poles or negative terminals of the cells are connected at the another point. Epsilon is the EMF of each cell and small r is the internal resistance of each cells. Number of cells is small n. This combination of cells are connected externally with an external resistance capital R. Capital I is the current passing through the resistance, external resistance capital R. Let small n number of identical cells are connected parallelly with an external resistance capital R. Epsilon be the EMF of each cell and small r be the internal resistance of each cell. Capital I is the current passing through capital R. Since the cells are connected in same order, that's why the equivalent EMF of the circuit is capital E is equal to epsilon. You know that when the cells are connected in parallel combination and each cell has epsilon EMF, then the circuit also has EMF is equal to epsilon. And the equivalent internal resistance is small r by small n. You know that when small n number of resistance are connected parallelly, then the equivalent resistance is equal to resistors of each resistance of each resistors divided by number of resistances. Therefore, the total resistance of the circuit is capital R plus small r by n. Therefore, external current I is equal to equivalent EMF epsilon by total resistance capital R plus small r by n. This is the final expression of current passing through the external resistance capital R. Now, in special case, when the external resistance capital R is excessively small to the equivalent internal resistance, then we can neglect the value of capital R. Therefore, we can write capital I approximately equal to n epsilon by small r. Therefore, I is proportional to small n. Therefore, when we increase the number of cells in the parallel combination, then current also increases proportionally. When the external resistance is very small. Therefore, when the external resistance is very small, then this type of combination is very useful. When the external resistance is excessively greater than the equivalent internal resistance, then we can neglect the value of internal resistances. That's why you can write I approximately equal to epsilon by capital R. This gives I approximately equal to small I, that is external current is equal to the current produced by single cell, and the external current does not depend on the number of cells. Therefore, when the external resistance is very high with respect to the internal resistances, then parallel combination of cells is not useful. This is the figure of mixed combination of electric cells. Here, N into M, number of identical cells are connected in mixed combination of cells. Each row has N number of cells. Each row has N number of cells. And there are m number of rows connected parallelly in same order. Epsilon be the EMF of each cell and small r be the internal resistance of each cell. And this mixed combination is connected with an external resistance capital R, I be the current passing through capital R. Capital R be the resistance of external wire and capital I be the current passing through capital R. EMF of each row is N into epsilon and internal resistance of each row is n into smaller. You know that n number of cells are connected in series in each row and each cell has epsilon EMF. That's why total EMF of each row is n into epsilon. Similarly, each cell has internal resistance smaller. Therefore, total internal resistance of each row is n into smaller. Equivalent EMF of the circuit is capital E is equal to n into epsilon. You know that m number of rows are connected parallelly. Therefore, the EMF of the circuit also equal to the EMF of each row. That's why equivalent EMF of the circuit is equal to N into epsilon. Equivalent internal resistance of the circuit is N into small r by M. N into small r by M. Because each row has N into small r internal resistance and M number of resistors, internal resistors are connected parallelly. That's why the equivalent resistance of the internal resistance of the circuit is N into small r by small m. Therefore, total resistance of the circuit is capital R plus N small r by M. Capital R plus N into small r by M. Therefore, current I is equal to equivalent EMF N into epsilon by total resistance of the circuit capital R plus N into small r by M. This gives capital I is equal to N M epsilon by M into capital R plus N into small r. This is the final expression for current of the mixed combination of cells. This is a very important expression. We know this is the expression of current passing through the external resistance. Now we have to find out the condition for maximum current. For maximum value of capital I, its numerator, that is M capital R N to small r, will be minimum. Now we can write M R capital R plus N into small r is equal to under root of M R minus under root of N into small r whole square plus 2 into root over of M N capital R small r. For minimum value of small m capital R plus N into small r, we have M R minus root over of N into small r whole square is equal to 0. You know that the minimum value of whole square is equal to 0. Therefore, small m capital R is equal to N into small r. This is the condition for maximum value of capital I or current. This is the condition for maximum value of capital I. Now we can put this value in the previous expression. We can get the maximum value of current. Therefore, maximum value of I is I max is equal to N M epsilon by 2 into small m capital R. This gives I max is equal to N epsilon by 2 R. This is the maximum value of current of the mixed combination of cells. This is the end of our topic. I think you like my discussion and my videos. Please click the like button and please subscribe my channel. Your subscription encourage me to prepare another video. Thank you for watching my video.